Okay, and make sure the options are good. Thing being the TV volume. I think 3 is good, right, for options. Yeah, I just do 4 because I'm not sure if it was all the way up. Oh, there's no more options within that. Okay. What is this? Yeah, I'm not too sure what that is. Oops, I need to put this on my phone first. Yeah, I guess last time I did finish the game without realizing it. That was weird. It's like, how did I finish Cat Quest without realizing I finished it? Okay, I gotta put this down, get that out of the way. Oh shoot. I didn't switch controls. Oh, 1 second, god damn it, I didn't switch. Okay. Jesus. Finally. How much freaking stuff to give me? Probably nothing. Yeah, because they're doing what is remake of The Last of Us 2. It's like, that is stupid, but whatever. Just in the sense of, freaking, like, you could choose not to, but you don't have to, obviously. But on the other hand, as well, I think it's a lot better than microtransactions. Maybe I'm weird for thinking that, but I don't know, it's just me. Then a game would be better than a microtransaction. It's just the pricing's stupid, I'm not gonna lie. Like, it's gonna be probably $90. It would be cool if there's an upgrade path, but probably not. Yeah, I think. I should level up soon. Yeah, it's like I already got all the stuff. Well, except flying though. I keep forgetting the circle. Oh, that's the dog. I have armor and helm. Okay. Yeah, that does a lot more magic. Do one more attack speed or more health. Yeah, I think I want more health. Oops. But I could level it up, so... Oh, can she not upgrade? Not enough gold. Oh, you can, but yeah, she doesn't have. I mean, I don't have enough gold. Okay, I didn't understand. Is there a reason why I'm not getting any XP? Oh, I get it. I didn't understand at first. It was full health, but for some reason I didn't understand that. Yeah, I don't know. Oh no, I level up. That was just... I don't know where the freaking thing is. The XP bar. I guess it's not like, the first game where it's like it would be right on your screen, it's somewhere else. Probably somewhere like in the menus, it's hidden. Yeah, but even if it is hitting, it's like whatever. Oh, I already did this cave, I think. Yeah, this is like whatever if I die, because yeah, it's not like the first game you have an ally, and yeah, it doesn't really matter if you die. Okay, now. Oops. Yeah, I'll probably do that. With that Final Fantasy game. Final Fantasy Stranger of Paradise, I think it's called. Like, I'll probably buy it. I don't know when. Hunt you now. Second game is kind of easier than the first. Because all of us, you could revive each other. There we go. I was just talking, so I muted it. To my roommate, and just in case you wanted, I don't know, I just do. Whenever I'm talking to someone, I just mute it. Because I don't know, it still feel like there should be at least some privacy. Yeah, I was gonna say that. Like, when I get, what is it? Oh yeah, when I get Strange of Paradise, or whatever it's called. See, could just revive each other. So there's really little need to be freaking cautious. Oh great, the washing machine is going stupid. Okay, there we go. It wasn't very long. That was weird. Whatever. Follow the light. Nick, I think that's what they need. But follow the light. That's what they did mean. Okay. But yeah, there was this one review on that game, Final Fantasy Stranger Paradise, I think it's called, and he was complaining that this game doesn't feel like Call of Duty. It has a drop down, not a drop down menu, it like has a menu for talking to NPCs and all this nonsense, and it's like, okay. And it's like he said, oh, I paid $70 for this. It's like, no, duh, you don't like the game because you paid $70 for it. But someone who, like me, who is hopefully gonna get the game and its season pass for like 20, maybe $30, it's like, obviously, I'm not going to be disappointed. Like, honestly, I just think it matters. Yeah, but, like how much you pay for a game. Obviously, you're not gonna like it if you pay a huge amount of money for a game. Because obviously, the price also affects, like, how critical you are of the game. I know it may be kinda dumb, but it's true. Thank you. Cam because I'm on a quest. So yeah, I really don't know. Is it the end? Yeah, obviously the second game is a lot better than the first. So I don't know if they do that, but it seems to be that's the case. And that, yeah, they purposely make the first game bad, then make it better over time. More with the next game. Because, yeah, they want returning players. So, yeah, they make the first one just not that good. But that kind of sucks, honestly. god, I need... Oh wait, oh no, freaking up. That was so stupid, they turned it off and turned it back on. It's like, I don't know what they're doing. It's like, they turn it off and turn it back on, like assholes. I don't know what they're doing, it seems. God damn. Should I be like muting the mic? No, it seems no. He could try counting them all, I guess.
Well, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9
bags, but I don't know if they're lying. Probably not. Yeah, we have that. I'm just trying to think. Yeah, we have half a jug of milk. I think that's enough for now, at least. Just trying to think.
Hi, Kenny!
Yeah. So, what else would there be? Obviously, I'm trying to think of the games like, there's, freaking, what is that game? Saints Row. The new one. It's like, I'm not gonna get that game. Yeah, I'm not gonna get that game for a long time, I think. Because, yeah, at least on PSN, it's $60 with the DLC. Just so you know, I'm probably gonna get it at $20. Or really try to. Because honestly, yeah, I could be wrong, but I think that's what it's worth. And if I am wrong, it's like, whatever. It's the same with Final Fantasy 16. If I'm wrong about the game, and it is actually good, it's like, whatever. That was my fault, because I accidentally pressed the touchpad. God damn it. Because I didn't know what that said. It's like with, yeah, I think I said that quite a few times with this guy. It's like I'm going back and forth so much. I don't know if I want it or not. Like, obviously I want it, but for $80. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, maybe that sounds silly, but yeah, for $80, I just don't know. But yeah, I have a long time to think about it. But yeah, I'm probably leaning on no. Yeah, I'm leaning on no because. Oh, goddamn. What is it? Oh, yeah, that. Because, yeah, I already have. Like you said before, I have, like. How many games do you say you have? Like 300 plus games? Yeah, 300 plus games and. What is. God damn, I don't remember. Oh yeah, it being $80 is freaking whatever. I don't know why, I'm just a scatterbrained, I guess. And it's on like October, what, 2nd? This guy 7 is releasing on October 7th, and like Black Friday is kind of right around the corner, so it's like I could either get one game for $80 or I could get three or four games. Like, for probably $100. I know it's a bit more, but obviously I would have more games as well, though. So it's like, yeah, I kind of think it's a fair trade. Yeah, people might not think it's fair trade, but I sure do. Like, getting more than one game for $80. There's, what is it? Oh yeah, Tower of Fantasy I'm gonna get. Like, obviously. But it costs $15. It's like, why does it cost that much? Like, personally, I think, it costs, $15 because it's in early access. But it's like, okay, but why does it cost $15? It should cost only $5. Because obviously it's a free to play game, okay. And you're charging $15? It's like, why? You get all your money back with gacha purchases, because it's a gacha game. So all the gacha purchases, or whatever microtransaction purchases, will be way more than enough. So I don't know, I'm just like refusing out of protest kind of thing. And it's like, whatever, dude. There we go. Yeah, it should be there tomorrow, right? Because today, I just gotta look at the time. Freaking stick drift. God damn, stick drift. Let's see what day. Oh, it's the 16th. Jesus, why is it coming so freaking late? Because, yeah, I really just don't understand that. I just seeing something if it's being dumb again. I mean, still, yeah, it is. So I don't know. Where? Oh yeah, I go back Twitch. Oops. One second. Yeah, I'll probably play for wait, it's 1:17. So what would that be? S ground. Yeah, they had old master's hand. I guess it's crappy for some reason. I think why it's crappy is because it has minus health on it. I don't know why it's minus in health, maybe because it sacrifices health for armor, and it doesn't. Yeah, it's just not better than my freaking current helmet. That's a problem. Yeah, I kinda like this because they're spread out. Okay, so that unlocked. Yeah, I don't know if I should go with a bard hat or not. Oops. Stick drift, Jesus Christ. Yeah, I think I Yeah, I think that's good enough. It's like, I don't know, I can't find a better one. Yeah, I guess this is the best one. I should, and honestly, I don't know. I mean by controller. It just sucks that it wasn't on sale, PS5 controllers. During the whole Prime Day, it's like they weren't on sale. Maybe they were, but they sold out really quick. So, yeah, I really don't know. But yeah, it's like obviously wanna do this. Maybe since I'm level 99 already, like I don't really have to, but whatever, still will. So it's over here somewhere. Yes. Oh, maybe it's this way. Yeah, personally, I wonder when they're going to do that. Do the PS5 Fallout 4. It's like they didn't do it yet. So I'm not trying to say, oh, they'll never do it. Obviously, I think they will, but it's a very, very little importance. Oh, finally found it. There we go. Where is it? Okay, there's a freaking Yeah. Seems a lot easier. In like offices, longer, which is nice. So, yeah. Okay, Thanos frozen. But, yeah, I should do more freaking side stuff. I'll probably go back and do side stuff. Obviously not all the side stuff. Yeah, that's so annoying. Doesn't do it right away. Yeah, I should do that. Yeah, I don't know, where that is. The freaking XP bar. That doesn't show it anywhere that I know of. That kinda sucks. But oh well. Yes, like I'm not trying to say that doesn't suck, but I don't know, I think you'll get over it. Remasters. It's like, yeah, I think people get over it. Because, yeah, I don't know that white knighting for a company is stupid. It's just, my thing on it is, yeah, it's either remakes or microtransactions. And I know they're trying to do like games as a service. I know that, but it doesn't seem that it's right away. Yeah, I don't know. Because, yeah, if you say so, I'm a white nerd who personas, like, cool. Because no matter what you say, you're always going to be a fanboy, this or that. So it's like, yeah. I don't know, I kind of came to accept it. And, I don't know. Like Jim Rohn saying that, like, everyone doesn't like Game Pass. Yeah, it's stupid, but it's just whatever. I mean, everyone hates Game Pass. Like, I don't think that's true. I just think he's half correct. Because, obviously, he said that before, like, you have to be within Game Pass's niche. And obviously, their niche is freaking indie games or microtransaction games. But if you're outside those two realms, sort of thing, then yeah, like, a Game Pass is not going to be for you. And I don't think you'll hate Game Pass because of that. I think you just will dislike it because obviously you might not want to see games go down that road if you're a creator where it's like, oh, to succeed, you either have to be in any game or a microtransaction game to succeed. And it's like, obviously, people don't like that, wouldn't like that. So that's why I say he's half telling the half truth. But my friend said that, like, oh, he's jealous of Game Pass and wants to make PlayStation a service. It's like, like, everyone does. Because there's a potential for more money. Like, even though you're losing money on freaking like sales, it's like whatever. If you have microtransaction games, because yeah, you could theoretically did a whole bunch of money for just microtransactions. So yeah, I wasn't dressed Sony who wants it to be their freaking cost to be a freaking service Microsoft, like really started it in the first place. Like I know PlayStation had PlayStation Now, but it wasn't like really doing much of anything, to be honest. It wasn't until Game Pass that PlayStation really started ramping everything up. Oh shoot, I need a drink of water, I'll need it. There we go. But yeah. It's like, obviously, I think PlayStation will get there eventually with making freaking a PlayStation a service, but There we go. But yeah, I think Sony would have kind of done it at just a way slower pace. Because obviously they don't have the structure in place to really, yeah, to really freaking like go all out sort of thing. They don't have the structure in place, so it was because of Microsoft, like, they really started ramping up. And like, gaming was going to become a service, I think, in like, probably like 40 years, but now it's like, it ramped way the hell up because of Game Pass. This is like, I think now we have 10, maybe 20 years until everything's just a freaking microtransaction game. Because, yeah, it seems that Sony rather have that instead of one or two big whales. They want, freaking ton of tiny whales. Like, what I mean, instead of someone like just drop, just like one or two people dropping huge amounts of money, they rather have a bunch of people dropping like some extra cash every now and then, because they think that's gonna earn them more money. And I could freaking understand that strategy. Because, yeah, that freaking strategy is way more riskier. Yeah, it just is way more freaking risky. Because it, because that plan was only hinge on like a few people freaking, if they were successful. And instead they want to make it so there's a higher chance of being successful. Because yeah, they do, they're going to do that with yeah, I don't know, it just seems a lot smarter for, in a business sense, but a consumer sense, it sucks. I'm not gonna say that it doesn't, because that would just be a straight up lie. Yeah, it's like, I just want to see if that was good, and it was. So yeah, I don't think I'll do that. Yeah, I think that's, I don't know why she opened it even more. Because yeah, now she opened it even more, it's like, like assholes that are freaking obviously blaring the music or whatever is gonna get in more, because it was kind of muffled, it was closed a little. like, I only closed it a little because it was kind of smoky. Yeah, there's a lot of stupid things to do. It's like, that's why I kinda gave up on, what is it? Oh yeah, on, that. And there being, yeah, there being a freaking Cat Quest 1. It's like I got, the level trophy, and it's like, that's good enough for second playthrough. And that was it, because that was good enough, obviously. It's like you didn't need anything else, really. What? The funnest shirt is. And near the ocean and near the trees of black. Where the hell are the trees of black? Yeah, I don't know where the trees of black are. Jeez, I need another sip of water and my ears itching like hell. There we go. I don't have it totally over my ear, so I'm hoping that will like help me a little bit, because I think why my ears itching so much is because, yeah, when I put my headphone on, I have it over my ear, and it's like, okay, whatever. But then it starts, like, my ear starts, like, sweating, which is weird, but whatever, it starts sweating, and then it's like, I think it also produces more freaking earwax, because obviously it thinks it's under attack or something. So it's like that, and then that irritates my ear, then my ear gets itchy, then I scratch it, and obviously freaking then my ear kind of gets rashy, then it itches even more, then it's like, it's just so stupid. But if I like let my ear breathe at least a little bit, like, all that nonsense won't happen. Like, I think it will still happen regardless, because so god I'm hot, but it will happen like significantly less. Because like you said before, I could just breathe now, which is weird to say, but I think it's obviously true. Yeah. Yeah, I'm watching all the... What is it? Yeah, I'm watching most of the freaking thing. God damn it. 8 year shoot. Really good stuff and Prime Day this year. I guess the link it was so good last year. I think they toned it down. Because it was really freaking good last year. They just toned it way the hell down. So I don't know. I just didn't really buy anything. Yeah, I didn't really buy anything. I only bought freaking Prime Video channels. Like Prime, not Prime TV, freaking Paramount. Then there was, the Mike's Out of Place. Yeah, I think it's a little better. I don't know. I'm just guessing. But yeah, I did Paramount Plus, then Stack TV, then what else? Oh yeah, Stars. Yeah, Stars, there was, Hollywood Suite, I did, and I think that was it. So it's like, yeah, I didn't do much, I'll buy much. Like, I would have bought a PlayStation controller because I really need to. It's just, they weren't on sale. It's like, what the hell? Why were they not on sale? Yeah, do you want to do that for 3 hours and just stop and not freaking? Oh, that would be what? 36 minutes and a stop. Dog soldier arm. Hopefully this time I could freaking find where it is. Oh, I think I actually found it finally. Yes, they come. I need armor for the dog. Oh God, that was so bad. But I guess at least I know where it is now. I wouldn't think it was so important, but I guess it is. So, yeah. Oh, it's like, if you don't heal them, they come back eventually, but a lot slower. Okay. God, this freaking remote keeps and this stick drift is so annoying. Like, I didn't see those trees at all. Of course, it's low. Two 234. Like, I know what I have to do, but not how to do it. Because obviously I need to go across there, but yeah, it's not working. Yeah, that doesn't make. That doesn't make too much sense to try the first kings. But whatever. Up and frickin' revive. Jesus Christ, that took just way longer than it should have to revive the guy. He just wouldn't revive. Just absolutely refused. God damn it. This stick drift is horrible. Because I'm trying to obviously revive him, but the stick drift is not letting me. Like, I'm trying to move, but it's like the stick drift is just weirdly pulling me. Like, god damn it. Yeah, I don't know. I guess I'll do that when I get a new controller. Or even better yet, when I'm stronger. Because, yeah, that's getting annoying. Yeah, it's like, I don't mean to be whatever, but yeah, it's really goddamn annoying. Yeah, I think we actually have to fight him, but it's like, yeah, he's just too strong. So I wonder where it would hit the wall, and yeah, here it is. Hit a goddamn wall. Yeah, freaking everything is just a really high level, I guess. That really sucks. Yeah, I guess it is. Because that mission was level 100. I guess I first start grinding. God damn it. Oh, no, I followed the trail this way, not that way. Where did the trail go? I'm going in a lot of caves. It's stressed. Yeah, it seems like you kind of have to. To obviously level up in that. Yeah, there's another Cat Quest game. So they can probably get it not at release. So obviously I'll wait until it goes down price. Like probably not as much as the first and second one, because I got them for like $8. Well, the first one was $8. I think the second one was like $10. And they were like 85% off. It's like, yeah, probably won't do that. But yeah, Xbox players like saying they can't find games, sort of thing, like always thanks to Game Pass, like I got introduced to this game. It's like, I don't know, like Xbox gamers are just weird, I guess. Like, they praise Game Pass, but it's like, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but it's weird that you didn't bother to freaking, yeah, to find games. Like, why, I guess, obviously I was like that too, where, I wanna try new games, because there were already so much, but now it's like, I don't know, it's just, I kind of don't care anymore about the big games. Yeah, it's like, I really just don't know. It's weird. My gaming habits. Yeah, my gaming habits are just kind of weird, I guess. It's not like they were bad or anything, it's just, yeah, I liked indie games and I kind of stopped playing indie games and I kind of liked them again. It was weird, honestly, but I think I said whatever to indie games because, yeah, I was like playing kind of bad indie games, to be honest. and like, yeah, I really think that's why I stopped really liking indie games, because, yeah. Like, at least with indie games, I think there's a higher chance of them being bad. Because obviously they don't have the budget. And I'm not trying to say like, oh, you absolutely have to have a budget for me to make a game good. Like, no. But it's like I have played a lot of bad indie games. I don't think it's so much the budget as it is just management. Because, yeah, with, what is it? Oh, yeah, with a publisher, it's different. Because if you don't have a publisher, it's like, oh, you have a budget of $1 million, like Ninja Theory. Like, they said, like, oh, freaking making your own game isn't hard, you just need $1 million. It's like, okay, yeah, that's not hard at all, right? But whatever. But yeah, when you're independent or an indie, whatever, they mean the same goddamn thing anyways, whatever. But when you're indie, it's like, okay, you have a budget of $1 million, and yeah, you can't go over that budget. But when you're like, when you have a publisher, you could go to the publisher and ask for more money, and they might say yes, they might say no. But yeah, there's a chance that you could get more funding. But with an indie budget, it's like, if you have a budget of this amount, it's like you're not gonna get any more money unless you somehow earn it. I don't know how you would, by getting a job other than making games. I think that's the only way how you would do it. But yeah, that would be weird. I would think. Yeah, I don't know. Okay, there we go. Oh shoot, I was just running around, not doing anything. Okay. I'll do one more quest. Being this quest. Okay. Yeah, I'll do something else because holy, that was short. I didn't think it was gonna be like that. Yeah, I gotta find another quest, so I do a dungeon, I guess. Did I already do this one? Yeah, I think I did. Did I not do? Did I? Oh, come on. I want to do something. Okay, I didn't do this one. Yeah, then I stop after this. Because here's a freaking thing I actually didn't do. Yeah, so I wanna do the freaking main quest, but yeah, that's way too tough. God, it's another healing staff. Whatever. At least, I did something. Oh god, damn, there was a freaking quest right there. I didn't see it. Oh well. It said I'd end anyways. As a save. Can I exit or no? Oh yeah. And yeah. I probably won't play anything else today. Because I don't know. It's freaking hot and I just wanna get away from the heat. Or try to. I hope tomorrow's not the same with how hot it is, but probably. But anyways, I'm gonna end, and oh, I'll say one more thing yet. Like tomorrow, I'll stream, but I stream something short. Do you want to play this again? Maybe. Yeah, I don't know what I'll play tomorrow. But I'll play something short. But anyways, I'll actually stop blabbering and say thanks for all the watching, all the good stuff, and goodbye. Then I'll press the share button and end. Yes, stop.